Hi guys, Mo here from Ahrex Hooks. We're in the headquarters today and we are filming my favorite shrimp fly, which is Mo's shrimp. I've been fishing this shrimp fly for more than 15 years and it's an incredibly good fly. Caught many nice sea trouts on this one. I do it on different hooks. This one is tied on the NS156 in a size 6. But I also do it sometimes in one of our real saltwater hooks, which is the SA250. This hook is a little bit shorter and heavier. So it depends on where I'm fishing this fly. Sometimes if I fish really low water, I prefer to use the NS156 because it's a lighter hook. If it's a little bit deeper, I sometimes use the SA250. I use two hooks instead of weighting the fly. I'm not too happy about too much weight on my flies. I like them really lightweight. I'd rather prefer have a sinking line or maybe intermediate line to get the fly down where I want it. So let's go. This is Mo shrimp. I need to put on my glasses as well, I can see. So this is it's actually a pretty simple pattern. And I think the most important thing about this pattern is it is translucent. I think there's several things you can think of when you tie a fly or create a new pattern. And for me, it's not always about making an exact copy of the real thing, either a bait fish or a shrimp. It's more like to get the impression right. So maybe you could say that I'm a more impressionistic fly tire than I'm and doing things in detail. So this fly is more or less made out of dubbing. The dubbing I use is called polar dub. It's a synthetic, long fiber synthetic, which is really translucent. You can get it in a lot of different colors. You can get it in tan, light olive, and brown, and all other shades. What I do is that normally I mix colors. I don't use just one color. I use tan mixed with light olive and maybe a little bit of flash. For the flash, I use ice dub, which is the best I think there's out there for this kind of fly. So this one in particular is made out of tan, light olive, polar dub, and some pearl colored ice dub. That's it. So first step, what I do when I create the head of the fly, and it's almost similar to what I do with the body as well, I try to align the fibers. So what I do is pulling the fibers out like this, and eventually you will have more or less at least all the fibers aligned, because you only have straight fibers left. This is far too much for just for the head of the fly, or the back part of the fly, which is really the head. So we do like this. Now I have a nice bunch of straightened fibers, and I just take a little bit of that, using that for the head. And what I do now, which is actually pretty important, you can see here, I got the full length of fibers here, and I put the dubbing around the thread, but I don't do it on the middle. I do it 1/3 and 2/3. If you can see it, it's maybe a little bit difficult to see on the film here, but I got 1/3 on my left side and 2/3 on the right side of the thread. Now I do it like this. Just put it in there, secure it with two wraps, and then I fold it over. That was the first bunch of hair or dubbing. Now to mimic the head of the fly, or head of the shrimp more correctly, and you normally do like this, I cut it. I think you maybe already now can see this is very close to what a head on a shrimp looks like. So this is the first step. I used the dubbing I cut off just to put on a little bit of doubling on the thread to cover a small bump I've made here in the back of the hook. Like that. Okay. Next bunch of dubbing. Same procedure as last time. The fibers are still aligned. 1/3 on the left side, 2/3 on the right side. Around the dubbing thread, around the thread here. And then you place it like that. You can see now actually that most of the dubbing, the shorter fibers are here and the longers are here. And then you do like that. Pressure it back. Now you can start to see where we what we're aiming at here. I need to put some ice on it. Important, I think, at least. I use just regular mono ice. You can make them yourself, you can use UV glue in black or add color to it or anything like that. You can also use easy shrimp ice, which I'm ready made, but I'm a little bit old fashioned and old school in my tying, so I prefer to use these mono ice. Do it pretty quickly just by securing them with a little bit of thread and placing the ice on the top of the hook. Pressure the ice out on each side. Like that. You can always put them a little bit more precise when you have the finished fly, because they're really easy to adjust. It's bend them a little bit so they sit right. I think that's pretty okay. Normally what I do here is you can either secure with a little bit of varnish here. I think I rather probably should do that. Or if you're more a glue guy, you can put in some Sabagab or something like that. But I'm a little bit old fashioned and just use my varnish. Now we need to put on some antennas on the tentacles or whatever you can call it on shrimp. What I use here is unique hair, I think it's called. I use the color polar bear. If you by any chance should have some old polar bear lying around on your tying table, feel free to use that. That's a beautiful material, but it's not easy to come by these days. But if you have a chance, use it. It's beautiful. Same thing here. I don't like the fibers being cut off in the same length. I wanted to be uneven here in this case. So you can do that as well when it's tied in, but I prefer to do it before. So, nice bunch. Put the thread forward. Again, double the material on the hook. Oh no, sorry, on the thread. And just like this. Now we've got the antennas here. They might be a little bit too long, a few of them. I normally prefer to adjust this when the fly is finished. So I think that's what I'll be doing now as well. Next step, another color of polar dubbing and a little bit of ice dub. It's in brown and dark tan. That will create the back of the shrimp. A little bit darker on the back. I think most shrimps are a little bit darker. This is a brownish one. I do a pattern. I do this fly in an olive as well, or lighter colors, or even really light colors, almost white. But I think the brown one is probably the one I use the most because of the places I'm fishing. Shrimps do take color from the surroundings they live in, so that's why I'm trying to mimic here. Same procedure here, put on the bunch of dubbing on the thread, 1/3 on the left side, 2/3 on the right. Oh, sorry, let's just do it again here. Maybe I should put the thread a little bit further backwards here, like that. Here we go. Now you can see, I don't know if it's how visible it is on the film here, but it, you can see it's a little bit dark on the back than it is on the body. I'll just put my thread forward a little bit to approximately the middle of the hook, and I'll cut off these stems from the eyes. Now I make a dobbing loop, very easy. One important thing here, when you make dobbing loops and when you have a rather thick point here at the back, I think it's important to take your bobbin and put it around your dobbing loop to make sure that you kind of close the small gap there is here between the two threads. So that's what I've done now. Put on my twister here. Before I do the dobbing loop and twist it, I'll just put on a little bit of dobbing as a body, underbody. Just a classic way of doing the dobbing. Nothing fancy here. And I'll stop around the middle of the hook. It's fine that it has a small taper because a shrimp is always fatter at the head and then it narrows off to the tail, which is actually, this is actually the tail of the shrimp and this is the head. So now I got the body ready. And I do the same as I did with when we did the body, did the head, taking a bunch of fibers, trying to align them as well as possible by just by pulling it like this. It will never be 100% perfect, but that doesn't matter. I just need to have as many fibers as possible aligned. You can do this forever, but you don't want to be honest. I think this is more than enough. I'll place the dobbing in the loop and spread it out. Now you need to think a little bit how you want the tape on the fly. You want to have a more material at the back, which is actually the head of the shrimp. So you have more dobbing closer to the hook and then less the further down the dobbing loop you get, which will be the tail of the shrimp eventually. Here we go. You can use different kind of tools to unlock some of the dobbing here. I, for some reason, I become quite accustomed to use my scissor actually. I'm not cutting with the scissor. I just think it's nice to, you can use your dobbing needle as well, but I think it's pretty easy just to use the point of the scissor. But that's maybe a personal thing, what you think is the easiest. I don't want to get all fibers out, I just need to have most of the fibers out, but it's okay to have some fibers left, so it's a kind of body here. And I put on this one instead. You can, here when I turn this, I do it with not a lot of spacing between each wrap, but a little bit. Otherwise, the shrimp will become, in my opinion, a little bit too fat. And now I'm always halfway here, so this is why I'll stop right now. Just put it up there. I need to put in another bunch of the brown to create the back of the hook or the shrimp. So we have always try to have the brown back up, darker back up here. A little bit of brown or brown tan. Same thing there, you want to align the fibers. And again, you know it by now, 1/3 on the left side and 2/3 on the right. Like that. A little bit of the lighter color dubbing on the front here. Like that. Then you're ready to continue with this one. Now you can have a little bit more room between each turn here, actually, because you want the fly to be thinner in the front. I think this is about right. There we go. By now, and the only thing I need to do now is actually put another bunch of brown dubbing on the top here to create the brown back. But before I do that, I'll just make sure that I try to get some of these fibers out again. So it's, and here we can actually use a Velcro or something like that as well. And now it looks like, you know, it's thunderstorm or whatever, it looks a little bit crazy. But I think you can probably see the translucency on this fly already. And it, when this is in the water, it's even better. Again, a little bit of brown fiber on the back. Same procedure as last time, aligning the fibers. You don't need a lot here in the front, just a little bit to create some, just a shade darker on the back. Same procedure, 2/3, 1/3. And you have the back here. And now we're almost done. Just make a small head. For some reason, I always use white tying threads on my salmon, not my salmon flies, but my saltwater flies, but you can use any color. I don't think that's really that important. Let's finish it off here. Okay. Now, I think we're almost done. You can maybe, I'll just use my Velcro here just to give it another go before we do the final touches. When I look at the fly right now, it's pretty okay, but I want to have a more, all the dubbing is all around the body of the hook, body of the fly. I want to cut off a little bit underneath here. Just a little bit, just to create that, you can almost call it a shrimpy feeling. Another thing I want to do is I want to cut off a little bit of material on the sides, especially on the back. It's not a lot, it's just to create that shape. I even sometimes cut off a little bit on the top here, because I think it gets maybe too high just there. It's small adjustments, but it's a question about getting the taper right, and even maybe a little bit down here. And you can easily do that with a fiber material like polar dub, because it's not tapered in any way. I have a quick look at the tail. I think there's a few of, not tail, that's the head, but you know what I mean. Cut off a little bit there. And here we go. One last thing I want to do. Even though I have put on darker dubbing on the top here, I prefer to use a brown marker just to create some small spots. I know you can buy a lot of different markers, but in my opinion, I think the more expensive they are, the better they are as well. So I'm still, as I said, a little bit old school. I use Letra Set, which is a pretty old school pen. There's a lot of other pens out there, but this is a really great one. And don't get any commission. It's just a question about what is working. Just a little bit. You can do whatever you want here. You can do a lot of spots. I just want to create just a little bit of color on top, and even on the, maybe on the tail here, so you get a, or not tail, the antennas on the head here, just a little bit. Okay, here we go. This is most shrimp. It's pretty easy to tie. It's effective. I fish it almost all year round, but maybe my favorite time of year is from April until late fall, where you have abundance of shrimp in low water. And this is most shrimp.